Yo, what's up? This is St. Joe, soundsofgear.com. Today, I'm here with the Gig Board by Headrush. Really dope effects module. And I mainly got it because I wanted to play with it on my Rhodes. Because you can, it's like basically having a whole bunch of different pedals in a box. So this is not a review. I'm not going to go through all the features. I just want to kind of show you how you could use something like this on your Rhodes, or your synths, or your keyboards, or whatever. So let's check it out. So right now, I'm just in the output section. And there's nothing, I don't have anything turned on right now. But if I go back to the main section, I could turn on the different pedals. Yeah, man, like, and all these spots up here, I can add my own different effects. So if I wanted to throw, like, I don't know, some type of amp in there, I could do that. You could just change it up that quick. And all these can be edited. So, you know, I can go in there and edit all the different effects, all pretty much everything. You got IRs, all that stuff. So there's a looper, tuner, but I just wanted it because it's a flexible way to add a bunch of effects to my Rhodes. And like I said, I can run synths and stuff through it too, but we can go in here and we can actually change, just cancel that. We can just go through different presets. Or you can open it up and go to, like, say, see what that sounds like. Or you can even go by type. So those are clean tones, but I can go into something like, if I want a bunch of dirty tones, you can see there's like 66, 43, 11, 7, all these different tones. And I'm pretty sure you can add more through the internet. But I don't know if you remember, but the DigiDesign had this orange, like, amp modeling guitar rack. It was called the 11. It was an orange rack. All those effects are in here also. So I guess Avid, DigiDesign, whatever. But yeah, so you can see it says powered by 11. But yeah, man. And why I like this is because it's just, everything is all in there. I just have the Rhodes plugged directly into there. I control over my master levels. You can go through any one of these different things and just add whatever you want. But basically, I'm just kind of showing you some of the presets. So it just lets me really quickly change it up. Let's see. You got some ampy tones. So now I can go into those. See what we got. Turn on some tremolo. I remember seeing this, man, it had to be like maybe 2 or 3 years ago at NAMM. I was like, yo, that's crazy. Obviously, I wanted it mainly for like synths and keyboards and stuff like that. So I'm glad I finally picked one up. I bought it maybe about 3 or 4 months ago, but you can just see how quick it is to go through and start changing stuff. And these are just the presets, so you see them in there. They have different sizes. They have one that's bigger, more of a floorboard. So, you know, got the pedal, the actual foot pedals and different things on it like that. But for me, this one, being able to sit on the desktop is what I was looking for. Let's see. You can go to see what this is. And I got control right there over the level, so if it gets too out of hand. Of course, you can hook up foot pedals to it and expression pedals and everything like that. But for me, man, right now, I'm just running it straight. You know, I'm just controlling the effects directly from the little switches right here or just on the interface. So say if I wanted to go into this reverb and adjust that, I can do that. It's all touch screen. Change the reverb model. So let's say I want something that's ambient. Really dope sound design tool, and it's just fun, man. It just lets you add a bunch of different tones to whatever you're working with. Let's see. Not to mention all the different models they got in here. Like I'm not even gonna go through the list. Like you can check out the specs as far as the different pedals and amps and effects that they modeled, but I really just wanted to show you, just kind of share it, man, because I mean it's just fun. I dig it. Obviously, I didn't even go through half of the stuff that's in here. Let's see. Let's try some crunchy tones. Let's see what's in there. It's a little fuzz. So, yeah, you can dirty it up. Or, obviously, you know, if you just want to go straight new, let me say empty. Mm-hmm. No, I don't want to name it. Get out of there. There we go. I don't need to save it. So now we're just there we go. So I didn't want to save it. So now I'm just straight, nothing. And I can go in and start adding stuff, like say if I wanna throw some type of, I don't know, distortion. So you hear the difference already. Then let's say, I don't know, some type of tape echo. So you just see how quick it is to start adding stuff. And you can see all the different slots you got. Throw some type of modulation on there. Let's do this. And then I can also quickly just turn it off. Or obviously, if I want to delete it, I can do that as well. Let's do some type of... So yeah, you see, man, it's each one of these can be a pedal, it could be a cabinet, it could be an amp, it could be whatever you want. And it's just super quick to go in, adjust it to whatever you want it to sound like. And I just having all those models right there for me, it's like I said, when I first saw it, it was something that I really thought I could use. It's really dope for sound design, really dope just to add different textures to the Rhodes, to the synths, to the keyboards, to different things like that. So definitely something to check out if you're looking for a really flexible kind of multi-effects box. Man, it doesn't take up a lot of space, but everything is touchscreen. Like I said, lots of effects in there. So let me know what y'all think. Like, comment, subscribe if you dig it. Also, if you're looking for plugins, presets, sample packs, tutorials, all that good stuff, stop by the Sounds and Gear Shop. Definitely helps out the site and the channel. Till next time, I'll see y'all later. This thing is dope, man. Definitely check it out.